Greetings from CNS and welcome to this new episode of NTB Dialogues, a special CNS series presenting insightful and thought-provoking interviews with leaders to accelerate progress towards ending TB. This series underpins the urgency to step up the fight against the epidemic. 193 countries have promised to eliminate TB by 2030, while India has promised to end it by 2025. So we have only 135 months left to end the pandemic globally and 75 months left to end it in India. Business as usual will not work. New and fresh thinking is vital to imagine, or rather reimagine, every critical cog in the wheel to end TB as well as accelerate progress towards other SDGs. Today's episode of NTB Dialogues features a special guest, Dr. M. Sunil Kumar, State TB Officer of God's Own Land, Kerala State in India. Kerala is slated to become the first tuberculosis-free state in the country. Welcome, Dr. Sunil Kumar. We are indeed proud of Kerala leading the way for TB elimination, thanks to the untiring efforts of people like you. Dr. Sunil Kumar, can you please share with us your state's plan for eliminating TB and how it is being implemented?
Thank you, madam, for nice words. Actually, the Kerala TB elimination and activities started around 20, 30 years back. Even from the NTB time, National TB Tuberculosis Control Program itself, Kerala do have a strong TB control program. Even though the medicines were not available at that time at many of the public health system, the people used to have the medicine from the pharmacy and there was good treatment adherence at that time. And when due to the strong involvement of general health system, the TBV test symptomatic suspects training has improved a lot. That means around 1,400 suspects trained per lakh population per year. And in spite of high TB screening effort, the yield from sputum microscopy was 1% to 1.5%. That means the TB detection through sputum microscopy was coming down for last 15, 20 years. And when the program started in revised National TB Control Program was started, the program supervision and monitoring activities were strengthened. And also ensure that designated microscopic centers are functioning properly, availability of the reagent, trained manpower, and the other logistic parts was taken care. And in spite of the effort to detect more TB case by sputum microscopy, the diagnosed TB case started decreasing from 2008 onwards. The TB case load was decreasing. At that time, there was around 32,000 cases, and now it is coming down to the 20,000 cases per year. That means that this data is not only from the public sector, this is also from the private sector. And moreover, the notification, when we started TB notification, the private sector also was involved in the RNDCP, and 2004 itself, there was a strong private sector involvement with the IMA, Indian Medical Association. And so the private sector, even though they diagnose the TB case, they will put all the majority of the case on RNTCP itself. Only few may be going to private regimes. And this was due to the support from the Indian Medical Association. And moreover, with the TB elimination activities, we started integrate involvement of the local self-government in TB control program activities. And under the local self-government, at a grassroots level, there is neighborhood group. And this neighborhood group meeting usually happens periodically, every quarter. And in this quarter, all the health-related issues are discussed, and awareness generation in the community started increasing. And this happens with the involvement of health inspectors. They used to attend the self-help group meeting and convey about all the communicable disease in their jurisdiction. And moreover, the LST support for the TB control program activities came up through a minor support, like a nutritional support. And through the district panchayat, the TB patients were offered dal, oil, rice, and minimum essentials that is required for the support of the family was given through the district panchayat. And we have examples of the LHC supporting the TB patients to have their dwelling places, a small hut was constructed by the district local self government for the support of the TB patient. And now the TB elimination activities that is going on in Kerala that was launched in 2018, there was a house-to-house survey mapping of the vulnerable population in the entire state, and a population of 3 crore 40 lakhs patients, 3 crore 40 lakhs population was screened by trained manpower, ASHA worker, the multi-purpose workers, and self-help group members. They visit the house to house and inquire about their ailments related to TB. A printed questionnaire was given, and with the questionnaire, the multi-purpose workers interact with the field with the general population, and elicit the vulnerability to have TB was assessed. And a line list of the vulnerable population in each gram of panchayat was prepared with the survey. And now there is list of vulnerable population. Periodical screening is going on every quarter based on the score. Each patient was given a scoring system, like around 13 parameters were taken into consideration: diabetes, HIV, smoking, family contact of TB. Such a long list of around 13 parameters were taken into consideration, and based on their scoring system, they were screened periodically by the field staff. And moreover, during the field during the house-to-house visit, they convey the message of regarding the tuberculosis burden in the state, and also how it spread. What are the preventive measures that should be taken? And also we started talking about airborne infection control measures. And that is one of the major initiatives that is going on throughout the state with the support of education department, local government, social security mission, and also voluntary organizations. Then some examples, school children were provided with a handkerchief that was called the handkerchief revolution. And they were trained how to protect against the airborne infection control, and what are the cough etiquette that should be followed at the school or public space. And also we started off making legislation to avoid spitting in the public spaces. And this type of message were conveyed by the trained volunteers who visited the houses. And also, and actually what is happening in the Kerala is the people's movement against the TB with the people's participation and also the local self government. And another initiative that was taken at a grassroots level with the help of local self government, at each OPD, the crowding of patients were regulated with the token system, because most potential risk of transmission of TB happens in the major hospital where crowding is taking place. And this has to be prevented, and under the initiative of local self government, fast tracking of the TB patient, and also the token system was introduced so that patients will have a waiting area, and when the token is displayed, they will go and meet the doctor. And regarding the TB patient, they were provided with the fast tracking mechanism whenever the diagnosed TB case or those who are a suspect of TB case, they will be fast tracked to the doctor so that the infection transmission is prevented. But the major hurdles that we are facing in the TB control program in Kerala is the non-communicable disease. And among the TB patients, around 44% is suffering from diabetes. Not only diabetes, other non-communicable hypertension, stroke, all these are the major threat to the TB control program. And regarding the death rate also, around in a year, roughly around 960 patients die under the program due to TB. When we analyze this death and majority, around 90% are having non-communicable disease. So now our thrust is to linkage of all TB patients, this mapping the vulnerable populations are linked with a non-communicable disease control program, so that their NCD part is taken care and thereby preventing the death due to NCD program. And another initiatives that is happening for the Kerala is the incentives given to the TB, even from the MTP time itself. The patients were given incentive of currently it is 1,000, earlier it was 500 rupees to the TB patient for nutritional support. That last 20, 30 years it is going on, and this fund is through the revenue department and village office, and patients are able to get it in time. And our what is the future plan is the reduce the vulnerability. Already we have mapped the vulnerable population. Vulnerability reduction, that means the NCD, non-tobacco, tobacco control program, all has to be taken care, HIV program, and there is a well integration with the well coordination with the HIV program, NCD program, tobacco control program. And now the one when the annual decline of the TB case in the entire state is 3%. We have analyzed the decline in spite of all the efforts to diagnose more cases, and in spite of mapping the vulnerable population, there is ways to there we can see the annual decline of 3% of TB case in the entire state. And regarding the involvement, to find out the missing cases, Kerala has initiated a new methodology. That means scheduled H1 surveillance system. Yeah, at pharmacy level, the pharmacists are supposed to maintain scheduled H1 register to record the sales of psychotropic drugs, TB drugs, and all. And last 2-3 years, the Kerala, we have taken the initiative that under the leadership of district TB officer, the key staff, to visit the pharmacy and collect the data of the sales of the TB drugs. And state level, we have a tie-up with the drug controller of Kerala. And from them, we will be getting a monthly base the sales of the TB drugs. And we will search it through the names, and it will be forwarded to the respective district, and they ensure that they are notified. And if not notified, who is the doctor who is prescribing it? And we will meet the doctors personally by the DTO or the PSC medical officer and convince the importance of notifying the cases. And last October 15th, statewide, there was a campaign to create awareness generation at pharmacy level to maintain the scheduled H1 register and also to notify the sales of the TB drugs in the state. And we are getting the data within 2-3 days. So we will be able to identify the missing cases that are not coming under the program, and getting treatment outside the existing public system will be captured. And moreover, when we think about TB elimination, we have to take an initiative of initiative for diagnosis of latent TB. And the country is yet to develop the latent TB regime and diagnostic criteria. But Kerala, with its limited resources, has taken initiative to prevent the spread of infection and promoting airborne infection control measures, and also in the hospitals, the crowding is reduced, and such type of activities to prevent the transmission of infection is taken care. And moreover, and the self-help group that Kerala, what we call the Kudumbashree, also involved in the TB control program at the grassroots level, and they do have a healthcare person in the Kudumbashree network, and they will be inquiring about the symptomatic TB patients under their jurisdiction and directed them to the public system. And another initiative that to bring the private sector under our fold, we have taken the support of Indian Medical Association, and standards of TB care was conveyed to the through training, through series of training throughout the state for the IMA doctors. And moreover, with the availability of the CVNet service, Putum pickup transportation mechanism as an intro, it was entrusted to IMA, so that whoever patient is diagnosed, they were offered, public or private sector, they were offered CVNet service through the Putum pickup transportation agent. And another initiative that has taken from the program is to form the coalition of professional bodies, professional association, like pulmonary physicians, chest physicians association, Indian Academy of Pediatrics, APA, Association of Physician India. Their coalition meeting is happening to promote them to notify the TB cases, and also we offer them the universal DST for whoever patient that is diagnosed at a under the banner of coalitions. And another initiative that is happening in Kerala, throughout Kerala, to cap, you know, the Kerala, the private sector is also so strong, like public sector. The private sector hospitals, we started opening step centers, system for TB elimination in private sector. And that is act as an interface between the public sector and private sector. There is no demarcation between public and private. Whatever we offer to the public sector is offered to the private sector through the step center. For example, the DBT, the nutrition incentive given by Government of India, is provided to the patients coming to the private sector also, and also promote them for cough hygiene and also other public health related activities will take place through the step center. Actually, it will be the link between the public sector and private sector. Step center will notify and take care of the patients put on TB drugs, and their follow, their treatment outcome, all will be taken care of by the step center. Like what is happening in the private sector. So, what we observed during the last 1 year, the treatment adherence in the private sector is also be at par with the public sector. And this was step centers we started implementing since last 1 year, and it was launched by the WHO Deputy Director Dr. Soumya Swaminathan. And this helped us in a big way to have to get good treatment adherence in the private sector. And another initiatives that is happening throughout Kerala is the support through the LSG to promote nutrition to the TB patients. That already I mentioned about this.
Yes. Can I ask you a question, doctor? You mentioned the connect between tuberculosis and NCDs. So do you have bi-directional screening for diabetes and TB? And which is the biggest culprit of NCD, which is affecting TB and TB
connection? Good question, madam. Actually, diabetes, we started screening for TB patient around since 2003 onwards. And bi-directional screening we started only last 2-3 years. And what we did, bi-directional screening, when we screen TB patients among the diabetic, the yield was less than 1%. Among the diabetic patient getting TB, that was happens to be less than 1%, bi-directional screening. And it was a study conducted by the Central TB Division, multicentric study, and Trivandrum was one of the centers. And the observation was from the diabetes clinic, the yield is less than 1%. And another thing that we do, that is happening is convergence of the NCD, not only NCD, other communicable disease with the RNTCP program. Existing RNTCP measure, this step center act not only for the TB control activities, also for the IDSPs. Other district surveillance program from the private sector is also captured. The common platform will be the step center.
Okay. And what about the rollout of the new TB drugs, for particularly for drug resistant TB like betaculin, delaminate, and also the child friendly fixed dose combinations? Can you say something?
Betaculin implementation, we have around so far, 58 patients are enrolled in the betaculin. Delaminate also, all the interest medicine that was given to Kerala was utilized. And we have a good treatment adherence. Moreover, regarding the MDR TB, among the TB patients, among the new case as well as previously treated case, the MDR comes only 2-4%. And MDR caseload is very less. And around 95 healthcare workers are having MDR TB, diagnosed as MDR TB. And these healthcare workers worked outside Kerala. And they, most of them worked in ICUs. And they are not worked at a TB clinic or TB hospitals.
Okay. Also, you have spoken about latent TB infection. Do you think that to end TB, we have to empty this pool of latent TB so that we do not get any new cases of tuberculosis? And how important is it to control or rather end latent TB infection?
Yes, actually the new case, the latent TB, today's latent TB made flare up to the full-fledged TB in another 3 years or 4 years, depends on the immune status of the individual. When the caseload of the tuberculosis cases came down, we had to think of the population that is already infected. As you know, that around 40% of the community is TB infected. At any point of time, they may flare up to the full-blown disease. This has to be prevented. And for the reduction of the conversion of the latent TB to full-fledged TB cases, we need surveillance system. And regarding the latent TB, the diagnosis itself is a dilemma. One thing, this tuberculin, 1TU tuberculin is not available, and we have to depend on the IGRA, interferon gamma receptor IGRA test, and this is not available at a district level. So we have to have a tie-up with the public-private partnership and all these things. And even country has to develop a policy regarding the diagnosis as well as the management of latent TB. And therefore, when we are thinking about 40% of the community is TB infected, we cannot treat all these patients for the latent TB. We have to customize it and regulate it. And periodical surveillance based on their potential risk assessment, we will put them on latent TB drug. And that country had to develop a policy for latent TB diagnosis as well as treatment.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir, for sharing this inspirational thoughts and the success story of Kerala's fight against tuberculosis. And it indeed is a multi-sectoral approach, as what you have said, all departments have got together. And that is very important, because TB is not the problem of the health sector or health department alone, as Kerala has shown very clearly. Friends, you were listening to this new episode of NTB Dialogues, a special CNS series presenting insightful and thought-provoking interviews with leaders to accelerate progress towards ending TB. Today, we were in conversation with Dr. Sunil Kumar, the State TB Officer of Kerala, India. Be welcome to share your comments or reflections on this NTB series at www.citizen-news.org. Goodbye till we meet again. Thank you, Dr. Sunil,
for giving me the opportunity.